Alrighty, well, it's the top of the hour, so I'm going to get underway here. I want to thank you all for joining me this morning for today's session, Tips and Tricks for Navigating the Dynamic CRM Mobile App. My name is Stacy Mancuso, and I am a CRM application specialist with WebSAN Solutions. I do want to mention that right now everyone is muted. If you have any questions during the call, please just use that chat panel to post your questions, and I would be more than happy to field those at the end of our session. Get over here to slide number two. So if you're totally not up to speed with who we are and what we do, we are a Silver Certified Microsoft Dynamics partner specializing in IT consulting and hosted solutions for Dynamics GP and CRM. We do have a whole slew of videos covering a variety of topics that we offer solutions for on our YouTube channel, so please take note of that address and check those out when you have some time. We do offer some interactive online courses through WebSAN University, so that's a site that allows you to choose content which is relevant for your needs while learning at your own pace and on a schedule that fits yours. And of course, if you want to learn more about us, you can always go to our website or shoot us an email. And that's me there at the bottom of the page hugging a tree. So today's agenda. So as we get underway here, I just want to give you a quick rundown of what we're going to cover. My main objective today is just to familiarize you with how to navigate the Dynamics CRM mobile app, how you can add and work with records, and lastly, how you can personalize your mobile experience. So as we get going here, how to choose your app. So when you go to your app store on your mobile device and you do a search for Dynamics CRM, you're going to be presented with two options. You're going to have this is the old icon and this is the new icon, and that's how you're going to differentiate which one to choose. So out with the old, which is actually named Dynamics CRM for Phone Express, and that is not a typo, it is singular on those mobile devices. I actually checked a couple of them just to make sure. And then the other one is Dynamics CRM for phones. And so really the definitive factor here is that icon there. I do want to quickly mention to you that this new app, this one over here, is only compatible with CRM 2015 Update 1 and above. If you're not there yet, please stick with me through this session, as this is going to be a really great rundown for you of what lies ahead for you. So what's different about this new app? This new app objectifies the Microsoft mantra of create once and deploy everywhere. So what this means to you is your experience in the mobile app is going to closely mirror the experience you have with your web client. So previously, some functionality was deprecated or was just not very fluid, providing for a less advantageous user experience, but not anymore. So with that, I'm going to get diving in here to my demo. So let me switch here to my other screen. So I'm just going to ask you to please bear with me here. I'm actually going to have to do a lot of screen swapping here to actually show you my device. So I'm going to switch screens here, and you should now be seeing my other monitor that is actually going to mirror for you an iPhone. So we're going to be doing today's demo through an iPhone. So I just want to kind of point out to you here as we begin diving in, you're going to notice that the screens are going to be reformatted. You're going to see everything you would see basically on your web client, but they're going to be reformatted, making them far more conducive to the smaller real estate you have on a mobile device without losing any functionality. So we're going to start off up here. So embedded along the top of your app, you have your navigation bar, and we're going to begin by looking at these four icons across the top going from right to left. So we're going to begin here on our main menu button, which is the far right one. Looks like almost like a little grid. So I'm going to tap that here on my iPhone. So this is going to take us to our different CRM entities and components which have been enabled for mobile access. And do note that I said enabled for mobile access. So if you have any custom entities, your system customizer will need to enable those for mobile access. Out of the box, all of the out of the box entities are already enabled for mobile access. But if you're seeing some that, or if you're not seeing some, it's likely because they're custom entities and they just need to be enabled for mobile. Next up here, if I tap on the magnifying glass, which is the second to the right there, pardon me, there, when we click on that magnifying glass, this is going to give you your search feature. So this, from here, you can either do a filtered search or a cross-entity search. So I'm going to start off here by just giving you a quick quick demo of how you can do this search here. So I'm just going to tap there, and I'm going to type in the name James. And as you see, I have it as no filter. So this is just going to return any entities which have the name James in them. Click on my magnifying glass to do my search. And when I do so, you're going to see as I swipe, first of all, some accounts came up, and so it found the name James in some accounts. As I swipe left here, you're going to see contacts, cases, and so on, leads. Now if I come back up here again and I leave James in there, but then I apply a filter, you'll see here as I'm scrolling, I can choose which one I want to filter on. So I'm going to do filter on a contact. Alrighty, so now I'll click on my search again, and now you're going to see as I swipe, it's not going to show me anything else because it's only filtering on contacts. So this is bringing up any ones that it shows has an association with James. So it might be their last name, it might be their association with the company. So that's just a little bit about that search functionality. Next up here we have our home button. So our home button, this is really where personalizing your mobile experience really comes in. And we're going to circle back to this later on in the demo. But this essentially just takes you to your home screen, which allows you to define data that is really most important to you. So here you're going to find any records or views which you have pinned. And with each consecutive swipe to the left, you're going to be presented with components of your chosen default dashboard. And again, I'm going to come back to this later on in my demonstration, showing you how you can pin some records and some views and define which dashboard best suits you. And then lastly here on the far left, we have our back button. So this is just going to essentially navigate you back to any previous page that you or that you had been previously viewing. So again, just similar to that back button on your browser. So we're going to jump back over here to our main menu button. And we're going to really begin dissecting this app a bit. So again here, we see any components or entities that we can select from which have been enabled for mobile access. And I'm actually just going to tap here on accounts. So when I do that, it's going to bring up my default view, which is going to be my active accounts. From here, we have a few different options. I can come in here and choose from any of these accounts which are active. I can click on my plus symbol here to create a brand new record. Similarly, down here at the bottom, I can click on these ellipses. This is also known as your command bar. So this is going to be where it provides you with some additional options. So here you see you can also create a new record. You can select a different view. So here, let's just tap on that real quick for you. Click on select view. You'll see here you're presented with any personal views or any system views. I can switch any of these views should I want to, so simply click on right there and I can change my view if I wanted to. So now these are my active accounts, Stacy's query. Come back down here again and I can also pin this to my home page. So I'm going to do that. So I'm going to pin that view to my home page so that I can check it out later. So I'm going to go back here and do my select view again. I'm going to go back to my active accounts. And so then you'll see here you have some other options still. So again, pin to home, you can refresh the page, you can actually share this link to this view with any of your other users within your system, if there's some data on there that's really important that you want to shoot out to them real quick. And you can also export this view to Excel, which is actually a really cool feature that you can do within here now. So let's go back to our active accounts again, and we're going to actually now hop into an account record. I do want to point out, we're going to use James Financial here. I do want to show you that if I press down here on James Financial, you're going to see that my command bar again pops up. And again, it's going to actually give me some different options because it's very contextually based. So depending where I am in the app and what I'm wanting to do, my options are going to change. So here you see I actually have the ability to activate or deactivate this record. I can delete it. Again, pin this record to my home page. So let's just do that. We're going to pin that record there. And then also some other options here. I can share this link again. I can create a Word template, or I can reassign this record to somebody else should I want to. So let me just go back here. Tapped on the wrong record there. Let's see here. Let's get back to James Financial because that's where all my goodies are. So let's go in here to James Financial. So when my record opens up here, you're going to see along the top that I basically have my header fields as they would show in my web client on my main form. So you have your header values up there. Up at the top there, you do see your business process flow, and this is actually new for the mobile app. Previously, business process flows were not in there. So what's really cool is that you can actually click on any of these stages, and it will expand it, showing you any of the fields in there. And from within the app, you can also advance to that next stage should you need to within the app. Do know that if there are any required fields, similar to in the web client, you will not be able to advance it. So if there are required fields, you will need to complete those before you can advance it, just like in the web client. So as we come down a little further here, we have our very first tile. I'm going to scroll this up so you get a little bit of a better view. So in my first tile, because we're on the account entity, this is going to be my primary contact. And there's some quick access functions you're going to notice here. Off to the right here, you're going to see an email icon. You're also going to have a phone icon. These are just some quick access functions allowing me to quickly send an email to my contact or place a phone call. As we come down a little farther here, we're going to see the rest of our tiles, which are going to display entities which are related to our account. I'm going to click here on Opportunities. And when I do so, I will be redirected to that entity, and then I will be shown a list of records that are related to my account. So these are all opportunities related to my account. And from here, I can easily select any of these opportunity records and be redirected to that record. So I'm going to click my nifty back button here and get back to our account. So as we swipe, I always want to say scroll. As I swipe left here, I'm basically given a 360-degree view of my customer. So I'm just going to swipe through each of these for you. So as I swipe here, this is just going to be similar or equivalent to a breakdown that you see in your web client. So just showing you the different tabs and different sections, which would be shown on your main CRM form in that web client. And again, you can tap on any of these to be redirected to that entity or directly to that record. So we're going to go swiping backwards here, because I want to get back here to our summary page and show you some really cool functionality that's built in here. So here on my summary page, I have my account number, and when I come up here a little ways, you're going to see a phone number there. So what's pretty cool is that you can direct dial from here. So I'm going to tap on this phone number, and we're going to pretend like we made that phone call. And what's really sweet is that once you place that phone call, once that call is disconnected, a page automatically pops up for you, allowing you to jot down the details of that phone call. So essentially, it's creating a phone call activity for you against that account record. So it's very similar, as you're familiar with that web client, with your social pane, where it creates an activity and then it just trickles. So it will show up in that account record for us. So that's actually just, I think that's a really great feature. It allows you to follow up on those notes immediately so that you can keep track of them and not, forget what you had done. So we're going to click on cancel here. So the next thing is, as we scroll up here, we have our address. So again, click on that address. And it's going to bring you to the default mobile map app. And that's a handful of words for me to say in altogether, default mobile map app. And this will open, giving you basically directions to wherever you need to go. So that's just another really cool built-in feature. It allows you just to navigate out to your default mobile app to get directions. And then again, just like everywhere else, you have your ellipses here at the bottom. Tap there to open up that command bar. And from here, since we're in here and we have our account open, you'll see you can, if there's different process or different business processes, you can switch business processes. We've already pinned this record, so you see you have the option there to unpin that from your home. And then you have your refresh. And I just want to quickly mention on refresh, this is for when, you know, if there's somebody else working on that web client and they're refreshing, you know, they're making changes to records, when you refresh here, it's going to actually refresh all of that data. So you always have the most current up-to-date data available to you in your mobile client. And then again, you just have your other options here to share the link, your Word templates, delete the record, and so on. Deactivate, reassign the record. So let me get back up here. And we're going to go back heading to our main menu button once more. So now I want to start talking to you about dashboards. So click here on our dashboards, and sometimes you get little errors in there. It just happens. So we're going to continue on our way here. So here on your dashboard, as you swipe left, you're going to see the different components which make up your dashboard. So, you know, it's similar to on your web client. You have your dashboard, and, you know, you can have up to 6 different components on a dashboard. Well, obviously, because of real estate and space on your screen here, you can't see all of them at once. So, again, as you swipe left, you're just getting each of those different components broken down onto a separate screen. If you click on the ellipses on any of the views or charts, it doesn't really matter which one you're on. You're going to get that same functionality. Tap on that ellipses. And you can actually change the view that you're looking at. You can change the chart. So you have those options here to select a different view, select a different chart to work with. And then you'll also notice when you're down here, you can obviously always refresh in case any changes were made in the web client. Down here at the bottom, you can select a dashboard. So similar to views, you can also change which dashboard you're looking at. So I'm going to click here on Select Dashboard. And I'm going to circle back to this in a moment, but you're going to notice, unlike you may or may not notice, but with views, we had all of our system views and all of our personal views available to us. Dashboards are a little different, just that they need to be enabled for mobile access. So I think there's only like maybe a couple, maybe 2-3 of the system dashboards that are enabled out of the box. But I'm going to go through with you here in a moment how you can enable those for mobile access and also enable any personal dashboards for mobile access as well. So I just want to quickly show you here. So I'm going to choose a different dashboard. I'm going to choose my Stacy Demo Dash. And now, I mentioned earlier that you can customize your homepage. So if I wanted Stacy Demo Dash to be shown when I open up my homepage, I'll simply click on the ellipses now that I've chosen that dash, scroll up here, and I'm going to choose Set as Home. And I'm going to demonstrate this functionality here for you in a moment. I'm going to show you how all of these records and views and dashes that I've been pinning are going to show up on that dash or on my homepage here in just a moment. So now I'm just going to really switch gears here and show you, well, not really switch gears, but we're going to continue on here and switch gears just in terms of I'm going to switch now to my web client and show you how you can choose dashboards and enable them for mobile access. So again, just bear with me here for a moment so I can switch out my screens. And let's see here. I believe I'm on my main monitor now. And let me get here to my web client. Alrighty, so let me just double check here, make sure I have you on my, yep. So everybody should see my web client now. So I'm going to just primarily talk right now about creating a personal dashboard. I'm not going to show you how to do it. Everybody should probably be familiar with how to do that. But if not, just come up here to click new and you can create your own personal dashboard. So you can either start with creating a new personal dashboard and doing this or just using one that you already have enabled or created. As you see here, my Microsoft Dynamics CRM Overview dashboard, that's just a personal dashboard I created for myself. So we're going to stick with that one. And I'm going to come up here and I'm going to click on Edit. And I'll wait for my screen to refresh here. So whether you use a dashboard you've already previously created or you're creating a new one, you're going to be here in this edit screen nonetheless, and you're going to have this option for properties. So you'll simply click on properties, and you'll notice down here at the bottom there's a box to tick off enable for mobile. Simple as that, pretty easy. Enable it for mobile, click on OK, save it, and then close it out. And now that dashboard has been enabled for mobile access. If I have any system customizers on my call today, I just want to let you know that this same logic does apply to system dashboards as well. So again, you're just going to go into settings, customizations, locate that system dashboard that you want to enable mobile access for your users on, and then again, just go up to the properties and tick that checkbox to enable for mobile. So switching gears again, going to go back to my iPhone. And we're going to kind of start wrapping things up here. So we're going to go back over here and we're going to click back on our home button. So now we're going to see those views and records that I have pinned now to my home dash. So you'll see here active account Stacy's query. That's the view that I pinned. And then you're also going to see James Financial, which is the account record that I pinned. We can tinker with these, making them larger and smaller, and also unpinning them should we want to. To do that, I simply am just going to hold down. So on this one, I'm going to hold down my finger on James Financial. And you're going to see I'm going to have an option here at the bottom to unpin or make that larger. I'm going to click on make it larger, and you're going to see that it's going to expand it, and it's going to give me a lot more detail. Similarly, I can press down on there again and make it smaller. So you'll see that when I expand it, it's giving me a little bit more data to look at. And then as you saw there, I can also unpin that record should I want to. When I scroll to the left here, you're going to see located here at the top, it says Stacy's Demo Dash. So that's the dashboard that I chose earlier that I wanted to set as my home page. So again, as I scroll to the left here, I'm just shown the different components of my dashboard. Again, like every other screen, we have our ellipses here. And this is just where we can, again, just set some additional, some different options that we can choose from. And these are more administrative. So again, from here, you can also create a new record. You can go into settings here, and you can either sign out, reconfigure that CRM server information, get some help, or get some about information. So that kind of wraps things up. I just want to quickly mention that if I have any Windows Phone diehards on my session today, I do want to tell you that Cortana can be integrated with the CRM mobile app to accomplish many of your tasks, such as looking up and creating records. So I really, really suggest that you definitely check that out, because it's some really cool functionality. I unfortunately don't have access to a Windows Phone, so I haven't gotten to check that out, but I'd like to get my hands on one because I think that'd be pretty cool to allow Cortana to integrate with my CRM mobile app. Again, I did demo this today on an iPhone, and I find that to be, I've had a really great experience with the iPhone and the CRM mobile app. It's been pretty seamless, and I've been pretty happy with it. So that really takes me to the end of my demo here. I do want to open it up and field any questions that you might have. So let me just click here on my chat and see if anybody has posted any questions to me. All right. Okay, so my first question here is how to use the mobile app to send and track set regarding emails. So Perry, my answer to you is this. It depends if you're using on-prem or if you're on CRM online. Unfortunately, if you're on-prem, they have not released that functionality to us yet, so I actually cannot demonstrate that to you because WebSense Solutions, we offer it as a hosted solution, so our CRM is on-prem, and so unfortunately that has not been released to us yet, but that is an app that you can actually download from the App Store if you are using CRM online. So I unfortunately cannot demonstrate that for you. I would be happy after the session, I can probably grab your email from the registration, and I can send you a couple of links on how to do that if you are using CRM online. Can one use the mobile device native calendar and link activities to CRM? Let's see, the mobile device's native calendar. So you're, I believe you're talking, Perry, just about just like whatever your calendar app is on your particular phone device. I do not believe, and I will check into this further, but I do not believe that you can just use your native calendar to sync with Dynamic CRM. I believe that would be exclusively related to like that Outlook client where you use CRM for Outlook and use that integration. Send an email to a contact and have it tracked. Again, I think this goes back up to your previous question there, Perry, about track and set regarding emails. So again, unless you're on CRM online, that functionality has not been released for on-prem yet, unfortunately. Let's see. My app, Windows Phone, just takes me to a wall and I can't seem to get anywhere else. Leslie, I'm wondering, I'm not sure, I know I've spoken with you previously, I'm not sure if you have CRM 2015, I know you're on CRM 2015, and I don't know if you have advanced yet to update 1. If that is the case, then that would be why that is happening. And it's, you're telling me it's forcing you to use the older app. I can take this offline with you, Leslie, if you want. I believe that it's because you're on... It might be because you're not on update 1 yet, so it's forcing you to use the older app, but I'd be more than happy to maybe take this offline with you and give you a little bit of just a little bit more information on maybe why that's happening to you and see if we can help sort that out for you if you're already on CRM 2015 update 1. Because as you, if you are familiar with the older mobile app, you know, the functionality just isn't as fluid as you were just seeing here. You just have a lot more functionality and a lot, just more of a web client experience, getting access to everything you want. So I think that I have actually covered all of our questions. If you have any additional questions, please feel free to shoot us an email. And so let me just advance my screen one more time here. So again, info@websend.com if you have any additional questions. You can shoot those over to, you know, after the session if you get started looking at your mobile app and you're having some additional questions. Just shoot us an email and I'd be happy to get back to you. I do want to ask before anybody heads out if you could please just take a moment to answer my exiting poll question. Just let us know how we're doing here. So let me just pop this up on the screen for you. Just kind of gauging if you were pretty well satisfied with today's session, if you got something out of it. I don't know. I'm pretty stoked about this new mobile app. I feel like it's the functionality is really great, and it's far more advanced than the previous one. So as you know, with Dynamic CRM, everything Microsoft, it just keeps getting bigger and better. And hopefully you guys feel the same way, and I'm really excited to see what's coming. I know that there's a spring update coming here soon, so I'll be anxious to see what comes with that. So as everybody's kind of heading out today, I just really want to thank you for joining me today. And again, if you have any further questions about any of our solutions or any services and how we may be a good fit for your business, please just shoot us an email because we would love to hear from you and field any additional questions that you might have. So I'm going to pop on out here. I want to wish everybody a wonderful day, and thanks again.